Hey guys, welcome back again, and in this video I'll be telling you how do you set up your action bar or your toolbar with navigation component. So let's jump into Android Studio and let's see how it's done. So here inside Android Studio, let me start by creating an empty activity and clicking on next. And here I'll name this application app bar navigation, and this time I'll use the Android X artifacts, because you know that if we don't use this, then we'll be getting an error when we'll be adding our navigation component library. So let's click on finish. So let's go to our build.gradle file and add our navigation component dependencies. So let's open this up here and let's define our dependencies here. These all dependencies you'll find below in the description. So let's click on sync now. And now firstly I'll create the two fragments. Firstly I'll create a main fragment. If you want a detailed introduction about navigation components, then watch my previous video. I'll provide the link at the top. So it's called main fragment. Let's create the XML, and I don't want to include any factory or interface method callbacks. So let's click on finish. And now I'll add my second fragment. So right click, new fragment, blank fragment, and this should be called second fragment. And again, I don't want any factory methods or interface callbacks. So let's click on finish. Now let's style our two fragments in the layout file. So fragment main, let's give it a text appearance of display one. And here let's change the text to main fragment. And its gravity to be center. Let's create a button here also. So button wrap content, height to be wrap content, and text would be go to second fragment. And its layout gravity to be center horizontal and at the bottom. And now let's go to our second fragment. Now let's create a nav graph inside the resource folder. I'll right click on the resource folder and I'll click new Android resource file, and I'll name it nav graph. And the resource type would be navigation. And let's click on OK. So as you can see that we cannot find any host destinations. So let's go to activity main to create a host fragment for this nav graph. So let's remove this text view from here. And let's go to the design tab, and let's go to this container thing here, and let's choose this nav host fragment. So now let's add this nav host fragment to this constraint layout, and it automatically picks up the nav graph from there. From my resource folder, I'll click on OK here, and let's constrain it to the sites. And now if we go back to our navgraph.xml, we can see that we have our host, that is our activity main. So now let's add some destinations. First destination is the fragment main, and as soon as we add this destination, it becomes the start destination, which you can see here. And let's add our another destination, that is the fragment second destination. So let's zoom in a little bit, and here I'll want to make a connection from this fragment, that is the main fragment, to go to the second fragment when we click on this go to second fragment button. So let's click here and let's drag it to the second fragment. And we can see that we have created our action, and this action has an action ID of action main fragment to second fragment. So now let's go back to our main fragment, and we'll find our button on view created. So on view created, let's find our button equal to view.findViewById. r.id. And I think we haven't provided any ID to this button. So let's go to fragment main and let's give it an ID of button. And let's go here back again and r.id.button. So button.setOnClickListener, new view on click listener. And here firstly we will have to find our nav controller. So nav controller equal to navigation dot find nav controller, and we pass in the view, that is this current view of the fragment. And here what we'll want to do, navcontroller.navigate, and here we pass in the action ID, that is action main fragment to second fragment. And this action ID comes from this nav graph. If we click on this, we can see our action ID here. Or else if we look at the XML file, we can see this action is an action ID of action main fragment to second fragment. So now let's go back to our main fragment. And now if we run this application, so here we are inside our application, and if we click on go to second fragment, then we are inside our second fragment. And if we press back, we can go back to our main fragment, but as you can see that the app bar is not changing. And if we click here, nothing happens to the app bar. So this is the purpose of this tutorial, to set up the app bar. So let's go to our main activity. So here inside on create, what I'll do, I'll find the nav controller, equal to navigation dot find nav controller, and I can find the nav controller using the first method, that is you can pass in the activity here, and second is the ID. And ID would be, ID comes from this activity main.xml file, that is the ID of this fragment. So let's change this ID to nav host fragment. And let's go back again inside our main activity, and here we'll provide in the ID, that is the nav host fragment. And here to set up the action bar, what we can do, we can use the navigation UI dot setup action bar with nav controller. And here we'll provide in the activity and the nav controller, which we have just found out using the find nav controller thing. So setup action bar with nav controller, and for the activity I can pass this, and for the nav controller I can pass nav controller. And now if I run this application again, so here as we can see that the action bar has the title of the main fragment, and if we go to the second fragment, we can see an up button here and the title of the second fragment. And you can change these titles using the nav graph. So let's go inside nav graph, and here the first fragment has a label of fragment main, so let's change this to main. And secondly, we'll change the label of the second fragment to second, or let's call it detail. And now let's run this application again, and we see that our titles have been changed accordingly that we have provided in the navgraph.xml file. And if we go to the second one, we see detail here. So now as you can see that this back button is working, but this up button is not working. And this is very easy to implement. To make this up button work, we can go to our main activity.java, and here we'll need to override one method, that is on support navigation up. And I should tell you one thing, that if you are using app compat activity, then you should use on support navigation up. But if you are using simply activity, not the app compat activity, then you should use this method on navigation up. But we won't be using this method, so let's delete it from here. And here what we'll want to do, let's copy this nav controller and we'll paste it here, so we can use this nav controller inside this on navigation app. And here what we simply need to do, nav controller dot navigate up, like this. And if we run our application, we'll be having our working back button, or the up button, what you call. And if we click here, and if we click on the back button, we are taken back to our main fragment. So this is how the back button or the action bar works. So guys, this is all about this video. If you have liked the video, do hit the like button, and do subscribe to the channel if you haven't subscribed to the channel. And if you want, you can support me on patreon.com. I'll provide the link in the description below. So thank you. Bye bye. Tata. Take care. Have a good day. God bless you all.